This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Go to the fourth floor to find LPs for a song.
We sell everything from dollar records all the way up to collector's items.
Head to the back of the store for 18-inch Indian crepes.
A variety of fillings. It's very delicious.
Step back two centuries for barehanded baseball.
We have two or three players out with broken fingers right now.
To do as the British do, go where?
When I think of tea, I don't necessarily think of Walpole, Massachusetts.
These gems are easy to like, but hard to find. We lead the way. Romance.
Many couples have their very first date on the bridge.
Intrigue.
A secret staircase, a hidden writing desk.
Hidden gems, next on Chronicle.
Good evening, everyone. It's time to put on your dancing shoes, warm up your pitching arm, and work up an appetite.
Our program is packed with activities tonight, every one of them under the radar. Ted Reinstein starts us off with two hidden gems in one.
Shalimar Indian Food and Spice in Central Square offers all you need to make authentic Indian cuisine. But why cook yourself when you can go to the back and chow down at the store's delicious Dosa factory?
Dosa is an Indian crepe. It's about 18 inches, and we have a variety of fillings. It's very delicious.
Pavan Pabla should know. His father started Dosa factory in the back of what was then his grandfather's grocery store.
It sort of is hidden, but it's been very popular, and the response has been great from the Cambridge community.
But wait, there's more. Bao Nation, tucked like a Russian doll inside Pavan's father's restaurant, inside his grandfather's store.
We went to a couple restaurants in New York and we loved the idea of Bao. The bun is steamed. We use fresh meats and braised pork belly, chicken, that's followed by all the toppings, you know, the pickled onions and the cilantro. The very best seller we have is the central Bao.
Bao and Dosa, two unique Asian flavors available from a father and son within feet of each other. Is it rude to ask which one's better?
I'll say try both. You know, it's like a one-stop shop.
Another one-stop shop just a few miles from where Route 3 meets 495 is well worth the drive to Lowell. Tucked into the fourth floor of this converted mill, you'll find a collection of vendors united to create more than a local hotspot. It's a revelation.
When people get off the elevator, they have no idea what to expect, and their mouth drops. And there's this confusion and wry smile and bewilderment, like, what is this place?
A better question might be, what isn't Mill Number 5?
Hi, this is Pizzuti Photography. We've been part of it since the very beginning. We are raising our daughter here. It's a really, really fun place to be.
Serpentine books and collectibles. The amount of people that come into the store and just walk up to it, open a book up and smell it, it amazes me every time because they just love the smell of the old books.
Mill City Cheesemongers. We have cheese and specialty food products that are primarily sourced from small local farms in Massachusetts and other parts of New England.
We're a vinyl destination. This is a passion project for us, me and my dad. We sell everything from dollar records all the way up to collector's items.
A space like this can't exist in Boston right now. It would be too expensive. Something like this can only exist in a city like Lowell.
When developer Jim Lachulis started designing the space, he didn't need to look far for inspiration.
What was Lowell like in its heyday? You know, we see black and white photos. It was amazing. We brought back an old-fashioned soda fountain. A lot of people don't know. Supposedly the first soda fountain started in Lowell. We wanted to recreate those things here.
The Luna Theater, Mill No. 5's crown jewel, embodies that goal.
Lowell used to have a great history of movie palaces and theaters, so that seemed a good fit here. The popcorn machine is mid-century vintage. The arcade games, they're all in free play. We have live jazz on Thursday nights, which is also free, and people can come and hang out more casually.
The emphasis on community is in full bloom on Sundays when a farmer's market takes over the space and live music fills the air.
Locally made award-winning three pepper ketchup, a marriage of ketchup, cocktail sauce, and salsa. It's guaranteed to put a smile on your tongue.
You can even bring a friend.
The mill is dog-friendly to friendly dogs.
A place this special is bound to grow, leading that expansion is Sutra Studios.
We're 4 floors up and soon to be 4 and 5 floors up. We are a yoga studio that offers classes, meditation, Reiki, massage, and we're really excited about making Lowell a better place.
Jen Howell is the director here. In her classes, she mixes Warrior One with Humor 101.
There's no way we're gonna hang out in plank while we're being filmed, guys, okay?
To create a space that is spiritual and fun.
The reason that I find humor is so important is that we take ourselves way too seriously all of the time. And if we can learn how to take ourselves not too seriously when we're on our mats, then we really can start to find more humor in difficult places in our regular everyday lives.
A positive message, and one that Mill Number 5 is using to attract a diverse group of people to Lowell.
It's kind of beautiful to see a large, diverse demographic coming together to work on themselves and work on happiness.
And Mill Number 5 developer says he was inspired by another Lowell institution, Western Avenue Studios, a converted mill turned into an artist community home to 300 artists, and they often have open studio events.
Right, and Mill Number 5 also tries to celebrate the history of Lowell. Lowell, of course, had the first mills in the country, and in the 1850s, in their heyday, they made enough fabric every year to circle the earth twice. So they were cranking it out there, and there's great history there.
All right, ladies, this breaks for you.
Women needed time out, especially. So that's what we do here.